So we assume that A is a expectation observable is a constant of motion, and we know that for any Hermitian operator A, we can have a unitary operator U. So every Hermitian operator generates a unitary operator that we have already learned in the last chapter. So you can write it as U A, because A generates U. So A as write A as suffix, then U is a function of epsilon. Epsilon is a very very small factor, and that unitary operator you can write it as e to the power of minus I epsilon A. So epsilon is a very small parameter. For the time being, you can neglect, you can ignore that. So this case, actually epsilon can be vector or scalar, depending upon A is vector or scalar. That is for the time being, you can ignore that. So this you can write it as 1 minus I epsilon E. So I told you unitary means it is very near to unit. It is very near to 1. So it is almost 1. The difference is this much, only this much. Minus I epsilon A. Okay. So this is almost very close to 1. Because epsilon is very, very small. So instead of UA, you can write either like this, 1 minus I epsilon A, neglect higher terms. Okay. So who is this one? Who is this DE without a different name? With a different name, who is that? Who is this? Who is this DE? Who is that? I don't know, somebody is here. Okay, whatever it is, let me continue. Okay, so UA. So corresponding to every Hermitian operator A, you can write UA. So that is a basic idea. You can write it in this form, e to the exponential form, exponential plus or minus. I told you in the so when you write e minus I epsilon E, this is becomes unitary. So you take U dagger or U dagger U, this is equal to I. That we have already seen. Okay, so when A is a constant of motion, we already found that A commutes with H, or commutation AH is zero. So that implies instead of A, you can write UA. No problem, because A and UA are almost same. A generates U, UA. So instead of A, you can write UA. Or both have almost same properties, same, almost same. Okay, so this is unitary, this is Hermitian. So every Hermitian operator generates a unitary operator. So instead of A H equal to zero, you can write UA H equal to zero, or you can write this commutation as UA H equal to H UA. Now you operate on both sides with the UA dagger on the right side. So that becomes UA H UA dagger on the right side. So this is H UA UA dagger. That is one. Because UA is unitary. So here it is one. So UA H UA dagger is H. Okay. So what is this on the left side? Left side, it is a unitary transformation, or we normally say that is a. So this is a unitary transformation. So if you do a unitary transformation for Hamiltonian, no change for the Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian remains same. Okay, is that idea clear? So this equation shows that under a unitary transformation, H remains same. What is U? U is generated by A, where A is a constant. So such transformations, we call it as symmetry transformations. This is what we said earlier. Under symmetry transformation, H remains same. So what is the result of that? So we can say the why it is true, because A is a constant. Okay, so A is a conserved. A is conserved, or A is a constant. So we can say that every conservation law, A is a constant means that is a conservation. A is conserved, conservation law. A obeys conservation law. So every conservation law implies the existence of a symmetry transformations. Okay, so conservation law means symmetry transformation. So we can say that conservation of law is due to symmetry. Okay, so what are the characteristics of symmetry transformations? Characteristic of symmetry transformations. So I think the idea is clear. What is symmetry transformation? Okay, this is symmetry transformation. A is a constant, so A generates U. So with the U, you do a symmetry unitary transformation, the nature remains same. That kind of operation we call it as symmetry transformation. So the characteristics of symmetry transformation. See, one more important point is the reverse is not true. The reverse of this idea is not true. That means existence of symmetry transformation, there is a symmetry transformation, does not require a conservation law. Does not always give you a conservation law. But conservation law is there, then it surely implies symmetry transformation. So the reverse is not true. I will write that also. Reverse reverse I am writing implying in the reverse not true, or that is false. Not always false, sometimes that is false. So conservation law definitely implies some symmetry transformation. Let's see, every symmetry transformation does not implies a conservation law. Now the characteristics of, so the I think the idea of symmetry transformation is clear. So what are the characteristics of symmetry transformation? First characteristics, it leaves the Hamiltonian invariant. You do the symmetry transformation, H remains same. The same thing. Do symmetry transformation, H is same. Second characteristics, it preserves the Hermitian character of the operator. Operator was A was Hermitian. Now after the symmetry operation also A is Hermitian. A remains always Hermitian, even if you do symmetry transformation or not. So symmetry transformation, under even if you do symmetry transformation, the operator remains Hermitian. That means observables, we know that Hermitian operator has real eigenvalues, or we can have the real observables, they are real expectation values. So the idea is that the observables remains as observables. Observables remains as observables under similarity transformation or symmetry transformation. So this is a similarity transformation. Similarity transformation by U or unitary transformation. So when H is same, that is a symmetry transformation. So these are the characteristics or two characteristics of symmetry transformation. That is second one, observables remain as observables under transformation. Observables remain as observables under transformation. And third characteristics is it conserve, you can all check this and prove that it conserve probabilities. Okay, and what is probability? Probability, we know that is scalar product modulus square. That is a probability. Probability is proportional to modulus scalar product square. Probability is proportional to modulus of the scalar product square. So this will not change. Probability will not change under a unitary, under a similar symmetry transformation. This all you can easily prove. Because the scalar product does not change under a unitary transformation. Scalar product remains same under a unitary transformation. So even under a similar symmetry transformation, scalar product remains same. That means probability is conserved. Okay. Now this property B and C, we have three property A, B and C. So B and C is true. I can say I is true when the symmetry transformation is unitary or anti-unitary. Even in the case of anti-unitary, B and C are true. Even if transformation is, even if transformation is unitary or anti-unitary. Unitary or anti-unitary. What is meant by anti-unitary? Anti-unitary means unitary plus anti-linear. Okay. So anti-unitary means unitary plus antilinear. So this antilinear operator cannot represent a physical observable, because they does not obey the principle of superposition. So antilinear does not represent, that is not a physical observable. Why? Because that does not obey superposition principle. So we can say that this anti-unitary symmetry transformations does not implies any conservation laws. So this anti-unitary transformations does not imply conservation laws. But they are important in such a way so that they give some selection rules. So anti-unitary operations are not important in the case of conservation laws, because they does not produce conservation laws, but they produce, if you study anti-unitary transformations, you will end up with some selection rules. You know, selection rules says some transitions are allowed, some are forbidden. So this anti-unitary symmetry transformation, it is useful in obtaining some selection rules. That is only their significance, but does not imply any conservation laws. So conservation laws is only given by unitary operators. An example for anti-unitary operator is, can anybody say any operator? Anti-unitary. Example for anti-unitary operation is what is time reversal. Okay, so time reversal is an anti-unitary operation. You cannot go back in time. Time always goes in the forward direction. Okay, so if you replace t by minus t, you will not get the faster system. Faster system is gone. Okay, is that clear? So these are the definition of symmetry transformations and their characteristics. Okay. Now we will continue with the, I have already told you that there is a close connection between symmetry and degeneracy. I told dynamic asymmetry or internal symmetry. Okay, so let us see what is meant by degeneracy and symmetry, connection between symmetry and degeneracy. There is a close connection between them. Okay, you consider an eigenvector of H as ket uk. So uk is an eigenvector of Hamiltonian with the eigenvalue ek. Okay, so operator is h, eigen state is uk, at uk, eigen value is ek. Then the eigen value equation is h uk equal to ek uk. This is the eigen value equation. Okay, now you multiply on the left side by ua, multiply on left by ua. What is ua? Ua is the unitary operator generated by a. So this above equation becomes ua h uk equal to, here also ua will come, but ek is a constant, so you can write the ek on the left side. Then ua uk. Okay, but we know that due to symmetry, we assume that a is a constant of motion. So due to symmetry, we can write ua h equal to h ua. Commutation between h and ua is zero. So we can change this ua h into h ua. So do that. So h ua uk is ek ua uk. See, this is another eigenvalue equation of h. Operator is same, eigenvector is this one ua uk, eigenvalue is same, eigenvector is ua uk. So this is, so ua uk is another eigenvector of h with the same eigenvalue ek. So compare these two equations, the equation, this equation and this equation. H is same, ek is same. So these should be same, but if they are not same, if they are linearly independent, assume that UK and UA UK are linearly independent. So if ket UK and UA UK are linearly independent, that means you cannot write this one as a multiple of, constant multiple of this one. So they are linearly independent. Okay, then we say that ek is degenerate. This is the degeneracy. Okay, the same eigenvalue, different eigenstates. So that is a degeneracy. So here it is ek, here it is also ek. Only eigenvector is different. H is same, operator is same, eigenvalue is same, eigenvectors are different. So if eigenvectors are linearly independent, one is not a constant multiple of other, we can say that ek is degenerate. So what is the meaning of that one? So the invariance of h Hamiltonian under a symmetry transformation. Implies what? Degeneracy. So that is a reason for degeneracy. Invariance of Hamiltonian under asymmetry transformation. So that implies degeneracy. So degeneracy and symmetry are closely connected. Okay. So degeneracy implies what is the meaning of degeneracy? There exists existence of an operator. Which commutes with the Hamiltonian. And here I am saying this operator need not be an observable. Okay. So the operator commutes with Hamiltonian. Then degeneracy will be there. So degeneracy means existence of an operator which commutes with the Hamiltonian. So that implies symmetry. Symmetry operation. So we can say that degeneracy and symmetry, they are closely related. They have close connection. If symmetry is there, or we will have degeneracy. So this is not a physical process. This is some internal symmetry, dynamical symmetry. Okay. So tomorrow we will deal with the space-time symmetry and other features. So today I am going to stop this class.